Hello everyone. What's the colors? Color to our dress. They are a leader and everyone is affected by what they do every day. Almost immediately after getting here, they started work as a volunteer in an organization that they are still a part of today. The work they have done in this organization has been tremendous and impressive. This person has helped and overseen many projects as a leader and volunteer in this organization over the course of 30 years. This person has been volunteering in the organization of Boy Scouts since he got off the plane in 1982. It's a great to have, and even better to teach. That is exactly what he did. He taught every one of us how to be good scouts and, above all, good citizens. This is something I will take with me everywhere, starting in my home community, 2020 Citizen of the Year, Mr. Bill Howard.
Thank you. feeling you are, Ron.
How about that, young lady? I discovered Cher when she was 60 years old. She's gotta be like 8.
Yeah, way better than Cher.
What? I'll find a little girl like that someday.
Yeah, well, she's not giving you a hard time. Oh, she's giving me a hard time about the same age. It was the 60s. I guess it still is. Peace, love. I swear. Yeah, well, tell us about what it was like when you were, you know, just breaking in, breaking out, doing all that stuff.
It was just it was wonderful and horrible.
Yeah, well, you know, wonderful and horrible are basically the same thing.
Yeah, right? Yeah.
And you think,
hear them.
Okay, you ready to stumble down the steps with me,
Sonny? I'm not sure. It's very dark.
Okay, this is going to be tough. Maybe you should go back and go. Look at those people.
Nice cue.
Yeah.
All right, we're going to get out of the way. I need to give this guy some advice. We'll be back in a little bit.
Okay. Oh, that's the next step.
Thank you.
Wolfsburg City now! Anchors away, dude. Who is up us?
Trust electricity, man! The man tries the microphone! He doesn't work all the time!
Yeah. None of this goes on Facebook. Can you find the longest beard? Okay. Here, I'll give you the mic for a minute.
I was really sad when you quit playing your flute.
Next year? Okay, girl, Lil Pop next year. He's back on stage. There it is. That's awesome. What's wrong, Rich? You nervous? You feeling groovy. People get nervous around me. I know it's kind of scary. But at least I don't have these on my head. But you got a cool name, T. How many letters is that anyway? How many letters in your name? Double me. You're wrecking my self-esteem, T. Miss Chappett and Saget in Speechless.
Let's see. your help too. When we say watch us grow, we'd like you all to say help us grow. So, with a whole lot of effort, Cordova Community Foundation was born January 1st, 2019. Nice, we can do better.
We can do a little bit better. Once the Cordova affiliate was accepted by that greater umbrella entity, Alaska Foundation. Watch us grow.
Help us grow. Convert those dollars into miles, and you can almost reach the moon.
Wow.
We are in a position to award grants right here in your own community.
Given out right now by our very own Angela Butler.
So our first grant that we're able to give out for $1,000, please help me welcome Karen Hallquist, $1,000 for Youth Survival Suit for Mount Ethel Swim Program.
Catch the promise, you will carry me safe to shore.
check this out. We got signs right here. This, you gotta already meet her. And these guys, they make food, yeah?
Okay.
These guys have been saving a lot of people lately. Yeah. We get booty from them. And Lyndon O'Toole, no? No?
Family.
Yeah, this is Miss Iceworm.
Miss Iceworm?
Yeah.
Sophomore Mia Stephen Morgan Cresswell, daughter of Mike Cresswell and Karen Stephen Morgan. She has grown for everyone and makes living here very special. Mia Stephen Morgan Cresswell. Sophomore Elena Escara, daughter of Cameron Hesse and Christine Escara. Spirit helps connect the community in an enjoyable and positive way. Elena Escara. Junior Maya Russin, daughter of Alex and Tamara Russin. Maya says that salmon is the lifeblood of Cordova, and the community of Cordova can be compared to salmon. We stick together no matter what and swim against the currents, navigating through rough waters while never leaving one another's sides. Here, Zaya Taylor, daughter of Nate and Emily Taylor. Zaya says, Cordova may be small and secluded, but that does not stop us from being any less a community. If anything, it makes us more of one. Senior Faith Collins, daughter of Mike and Carrie Collins. Faith says that no other community has demonstrated the dedication and compassion that this one has. Cordova can go through changes between summer and winter seasons, but keeps the same comforting feeling of a close-knit community. Faith Collins. Rhea Smike, daughter of Dana and Anita Smike. Rhea says that growing up in this town has taught me a valuable lesson. Always provide support and love, because you never know what someone is going through, and never miss an opportunity to brighten someone's day. Rhea Smike. Miss Iceworm, and the winner of a $2,500 scholarship is... Rhea Smythe.
Everybody kind of chips in and
that's right, we know.